Indie gaming fans, it's the X-Hardcore Gamer here to talk about the full release for DAP. A few months back, I actually did some demo impressions for DAP, but now we have the full game, and let's see what we can expect. For those of you unfamiliar, DAP is a horror action adventure about gathering and protecting a pack of fragile creatures called DAPs. When you go to play this, you're in for a very weird and bizarre story, but I do mean that in the best way possible. I mean, right from the get-go, you know you're going to be in for an odd experience as you find all these weird creatures and you're in this very strange world where you're never quite sure what's going to happen next. If you heard me use the words odd and world, that was not by accident. I definitely had a very strong odd world vibe while playing this game. It's rather difficult to go into any aspect of the story in this game without getting into spoilers, so I don't really know how much I'm going to be able to say. Just know, like I said, strange things are going to happen, you're saving the DAPs, and the more that you save, the better off you do in the game. It's not a super story-heavy game, but there will be moments where you run into other characters and you will talk with them, all through on-screen text. You'll be exploring different settings in this game, such as swamps and forests, as you try to find more of the DAPs to bring them back to safety. On top of having to fend off various enemies that you run into while exploring the game, there are going to be other areas that can lead to infection. If you stay too long in any of the infection areas, the DAPs that are following you will turn evil and start attacking you. Not only is this counterproductive, as it's the exact opposite of you trying to save as many as possible, when they become infected, they gang up and become a huge horde that will attack you and are very difficult to survive. Your ability to survive consists of you being able to use a basic melee attack as well as shoot energy. Obviously, the energy is going to be way more powerful than the melee, but unfortunately, there is a cooldown time. To counteract this, the more DAPs that you have on your side, the more shots that you can make before you have to recharge. The further along that you get in the game, the more abilities that you get, but these are the basic ones that you start off with. The DAPs aren't the only things that you're going to be looking for as you explore. You're also going to find resources to help you make fires and craft healing potions. Before you get too worried and think that this is more of a survival game, just know that the fires are multi-purpose, but it's not as strong as some other games. When you create a fire, it's going to be a safe space if you set it up within any of the infection areas. It will hold off any infection from capturing you or any of your DAPs, and it will also create new DAPs in certain areas of the game as well. Finally, it's at these fires that you create where you will also craft health potions. While it does say that a controller is recommended to play this game, I can safely say that anybody who's a fan of mouse and keyboard will have no problems playing it. Controls are the usual using the left stick to move or the keyboard, and then aiming is done by either using the right stick or the mouse. What I found strange was that any key on the keyboard could be remapped, but you could not touch the mouse at all and only two of the buttons could be changed on the controller. Luckily, I feel that the default controls are just perfectly fine and there's no real need to change them, but I wanted to mention it because I know there are some people that have different ways they like to play. Little side note along those lines, for those of you that prefer to use a PlayStation controller, there's actually an option where you can switch it so the on-screen buttons will match that. As I noted before in my demo impressions, I really enjoyed the graphical styling of DAP. While at first glance, it may look like your usual run-of-the-mill pixel art game, it's actually a lot more to it if you give it a closer look. When you look more closely at the different sprites in the game, you'll see that they each have these little lines and patterns in them that give it this kind of cool little engraving look that I really, really enjoyed, and I was glad to see that from the demo to the full game, there are even levels that kind of zoom in a bit more and have more lighting effects. The music is actually very well done, but I found that it had this weird quality to it where I would almost forget that it was playing at times. I would just become so engrossed in what was happening that I would just kind of even just lose sight of the fact that there was music playing. Back in my demo impressions, I said that I really enjoyed what I played and just hoped for more while playing the full game, and that's exactly what we got. More areas to explore, more enemies to fight, and most importantly, more puzzles to solve. It's definitely a challenging game, and so there will be some frustration, but there are a lot of checkpoints that will keep you going for more. In the end, your ability and playstyle will determine how much time you'll get out of this game, but they're saying that you're going to get about 8 hours of gameplay to be able to complete it all. There's a great charm to pretty much every aspect of DAP, and I highly recommend it for anybody who would enjoy this style of game.
Thank you.
And now I'd like to take the time to thank our indie warriors. Mitchell Hall, Bunny, Kevalo, Bill Tecas, Christian Cruz, Chris Jackson, Nathan Moore, Peach, Adriana Amato, CJR, PSC, C. Coyle, Skepticism, Jen Rose, Jesse, CPM, Julian Kolbis, and JRS the 8th. Thank you again for all of your support for us here at I Dream of Indie, as well as indie gaming in general. If anybody else would like to help support us and become an indie warrior, all the information is in the description below. Otherwise, thanks again for watching, and until next time, enjoy gaming.